In this introduction, you'll be learning to drive this DBBR-193 Vectron locomotive. During this introduction, you will be covering the critical driving controls and freight operations. When you are ready, climb aboard. Sit in the driver's seat. Use the master key to activate the control desk. Set the headlights to indicate that this locomotive is operational. Headlights must be used regardless of the time of day or weather. The direction of travel in a Vectron locomotive is determined by the reverser buttons. Now we can release the brakes and get ready to move. Move the throttle into the power range. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Come to a stop using the brakes. The freight wagons are behind us. Change direction with the reverser, then change the junction indicated either by walking over to it or using the map. The junction is correctly aligned. You can now couple up to the freight, approach slowly, and stop just before the buffers. This locomotive uses manual hook couplers which will need to be connected. You can couple and uncouple from either an external camera or on foot. Let's connect the formation using the external camera. Return to the first-person camera. Nice work. Change direction with the reverser and move the train forward into the indicated siding. You can couple and uncouple from either an external camera or on foot. Uncouple from the wagons on foot this time. Stand up and head outside. Nice work. That concludes the basics of operating this locomotive.
Welcome to London Euston, located on the West Coast Main Line in the UK. The West Coast Main Line is one of the busiest mixed traffic routes in Europe and one of the most important railway lines in the UK. Looks like there's a route map missing. There are more tasks to find. Be sure to apply the route maps, restock defibrillators, help delivery robots, and find football scarves. Follow the markers to board the train before departure. Take a seat. The train is just about to leave.
Smoking is not permitted in any part of this station or on trains. This includes e-cigarettes.
The main West Coast Main Line, which started construction in 1837, stretches 399 miles from London to Glasgow. Including the additional lines that veer off to other major cities, the route mileage comes to a total of around 700 miles. Initially, the line was not intended to be a single route, but was put together through a series of local lines that first created the Northwestern Railway in 1846, and finally merged together with the Caledonian Railway in 1923. The line's ownership has changed frequently over the years, most notably owned by London, Midland and Scottish Railway, thanks to the Railways Act of 1921 that joined many railway companies together. In the 1950s, the railway was upgraded to have electrification and newer intercity services with speeds of up to 110 miles per hour, with most of the line having a top speed of 125 miles per hour. This train is a Class 350/1 electric multiple unit, manufactured between 2004 and 2014, and is part of the Desiro family. Commuter action abounds along the bustling four-track West Coast Main Line in Trainsim World. Dash through the complex layout of London Euston aboard the hard-working Class 350 and embark across the northwest corner of the capital to Milton Keynes with expresses and stoppers alike. In this training module, you'll be taken through the operation of this Class 350/1 electric multiple unit. For this introduction, you'll be driving the train a short distance and performing passenger operations. Sit in the driver's. Set the master key to on. This electric multiple unit, or EMU, features dual electrification and can be used with both third rail and overhead electrification. Set the pantograph switch to the up position. This will raise the third rail shoes to disconnect them and raise the pantograph to connect with the wires above, swapping the power collection from 750 volts DC third rail to the 25,000 volts AC overhead. Set the headlights to daylight to indicate to others that this train is operational. Set the reverser to forward. This controls the direction of travel. You can coast to maintain your speed. Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of braking force by moving the combined power brake handle into the braking range. You're approaching the station. Begin applying a small amount of braking force by moving the combined power brake handle into the braking range. Nice job. The train has safely come to a stop. You can now use the passenger door controls to open the doors. Close the doors and drive to the next station unguided. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train. In this training module, you'll be taken through the operation of this Class 377/2 electric multiple unit. For this introduction, you'll be driving the train a short distance and performing passenger operations. Set the master key to on. Set the headlights to day running to indicate to others that this train is operational. Set the reverser to forward. This controls the direction of travel. On level grades, you can coast to maintain your speed, reducing energy consumption and stress on the motors. Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of braking force by moving the combined power brake handle into the braking range. You're approaching the station. Begin applying a small amount of braking force by moving the combined power brake handle into the braking range. Nice job. The train has safely come. Close the doors and drive to the next station unguided. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train. In this training module, you'll be taken through the operation of the Pendolino Class 390 electric multiple unit. To begin, insert and set the master key to OM. Set the headlights to indicate that this train is operational. After setting the reverser, you will hear an alarm. This is the tilt authorization and speed supervision alarm and will need to be acknowledged. Set the reverser to forward. This controls the direction of travel. The tilt alarm will sound for a second time. Acknowledge the alarm again. TAS uses communications between an onboard computer and trackside beacons to inform the train of the enhanced permissible speed, as well as disabling the system when not in speed supervised zones. When in speed supervised zones, the blue speed supervised light will illuminate and allow the train to drive at the enhanced permissible speed. When outside of the speed supervised zones, the blue light will not be illuminated and you will be restricted to the maximum permissible speed. If you exceed the enhanced permissible speed by more than 3.5 miles per hour, the TAS warning light will illuminate and an alarm will sound indicating that you must reduce your speed. The light will extinguish and the alarm will stop when you are below the enhanced speed limit. At more than 6 miles per hour above the enhanced permissible speed, the TAS warning light will flash and a penalty brake application will be enforced. To stop the penalty brake application, you must reduce your speed and press the intervention reset button. Open the passenger doors to allow boarding. Close the doors before departure. Move the power handle into the power range to get moving. built up some speed, you can return the power handle to the off position to begin coasting. The Class 390 was developed as part of a plan to overhaul services between London and Glasgow. Originally just an 8-car formation, demand meant that the Class 390s now appear in 9 and 11-car formations, capable of carrying more than 450 passengers. After 20 years and 300 million miles, Avanti's Class 390s have undergone a full refurbishment, preparing them for the future. Approaching the station, begin applying a small amount of braking force by moving the power handle into the braking range. Good work. That concludes all of the basics of operating this train.
The checks on operations is stationed. Please continue to be ready.